That's what I love most about you. And can I tell you how gorgeous you look today? All week, we're going to have an overarching theme of Venus activating the Saturn-Uranus square. So last week it was Mars. And so we're going to see some similar themes here, but Mars is a lot different. Mars and Venus have totally different styles. Mars pokes, provokes, irritates. It can be destructive. We did have the building collapse, and that has been like an ongoing, very tragic story. The story is still going on as of this recording that I'm making. We're still looking for hopefully signs of life and things like that. Also, another building collapsed. And yeah, so this seems to be a theme of Saturn, which is like edifices, buildings, structures, and Uranus, which is the crumbling. And I think that, you know, it is like, I mean, that's a very literal example of this transit, but overall, that's the energy that we're experiencing right now in the collective when we're looking at power structures and how we live our lives. So everything is changing right now in the wake of the pandemic. And that is what Saturn square Uranus aims to do, is to find the faults in the structures, and some of them will crumble, and then others, you know, we need to reinforce differently with an eye toward the future and an eye toward the now, with evolution in mind. You know, the needs of our society, the needs of us collectively are evolving, and it takes a little while for the laws and things like that to catch up to our consciousness. Basically, those things move a lot slower. So anyways, that was a little bit more, we had a little bit more of difficulty last week. Like, the stories were a little bit more tense. Also, we saw a flying car. So Mars is mechanics and Uranus is like aviation. So that was kind of interesting. But at the same time, it's kind of like, yeah, shouldn't we be focusing a little bit more on using this inventiveness to find more ways to live in harmony with our planet, like Uranus and Taurus? That was some themes. And we might see a continuation of themes here as Venus steps in to activate the Saturn-Uranus square. But Venus is a little different. Venus is, she massages, she entices, she's trying to bring harmony. So perhaps we'll see some sort of closure on this story, some kind of very like heartfelt closure coming in, as far as like the building collapse and the victims and everything like that. So we may see some conclusions here to that story. We're also going to see money. Money is going to be a theme. We know that Uranus and Taurus has been all about creating new forms of currency and bringing them more mainstream. When Uranus entered Taurus, that's when we had the big Bitcoin boom. And ever since, we've seen like more cryptocurrencies arising. So we may see some themes around crypto. Once again, Saturn is involved in this configuration. So I feel like Saturn being especially strong right now, there may be more attempts to wrangle or control or to legalize, but like in a way where the governments want a slice, right? Like, they want taxes and everything. Like, currently it's Uranus and Taurus. It's the Wild West with cryptocurrency. It's totally unregulated. And so there may be attempts to regulate that, more distinctive attempts. So we may see stories like that. Also, just in our personal lives with finances, I know so many people who have had to, just in light of everything that has happened in the last year and a half, reconsider how they live, and reconsidering their relationship with working and grinding and budgeting and everything like that. So this may be about implementing new awarenesses into our relationship with money and how we procure money and save it and spend it and all of that. So that we could be having personal breakthroughs on that front. Also, the biggest one for Venus activating the Saturn-Uranus square is relationships. Chances are we'll be seeing big breakup and hookup stories in the news. We'll be seeing that. Also, just in our personal lives, this is going to be big breakthroughs within our personal relationships. Venus in Leo wants to be seen. Venus in Leo wants to be appreciated. Venus in Leo wants to feel sexy. And so if you're not getting that kind of acknowledgement, it's time to have some words about it. We know that Saturn in Aquarius, you know, Aquarius is a sign that's very contained. So while we might be experiencing a great deal of support in certain relationships, Venus opposite Saturn. So this is about stability. You know, Venus and Saturn get along because we need Venus and Saturn to have long-term relationships. So, you know, sometimes we get comfortable, right? And so Venus in Leo says, like, I know you appreciate me. Like, I know you appreciate me, but can you like say it a little bit more? Can we get some reflection back? And simultaneously, it's about us giving out the love too. Venus in Leo is all about appreciation and generosity. And so definitely tell people that you appreciate them, that you think they're rad, that you think they're gorgeous, that you really love what they do. It's all about feeling seen right now, feeling seen and supported in a radical way, Uranus. So put yourself out there and tell people how you feel, and definitely share the love. Don't be shy at this time. Also, if there's any kind of flimsiness in the relationship, this can be a make or break. You know, Saturn really invites us to look at things realistically. Is this sustainable? Do I feel supported? Do I feel secure? Am I getting my needs met? Do I see a future? You know, do I see a future with us right now? This can definitely be a make or break point in relationships where we're trying to figure out if this is supportive for us at this point in our lives. And can we make some compromises? You know, that's Saturn really wants, especially in a fixed sign. This is all fixed planets right now, fixed signs. So we're really focused on, can we make this work? And if not, see ya, because that's the Uranus energy of, all right, like, I want my freedom. I want to feel appreciated. I want to feel sexy. And if you're not making me feel, if I'm not feeling seen and appreciated and gorgeous here, then I'll go somewhere else and get it somewhere else. So that's kind of what this energy, may bring to the table. It could also just be, wanting to switch things up in the relationship to keep it fresh and to keep it fun. Venus in Leo is incredibly like flirty and fun and vibrant. So we might just need to be bringing in a little bit more vibrancy and passion. That's a really big Leo word, is just passion. So do it up and create some new patterns in the relationship. This doesn't have to just be your romantic relationships too. This could be your friendships. Or creative relationships, especially, where we want to hype each other up. We want to hype each other up and make sure that everyone, Aquarius, everyone has their moment in the spotlight. So that's a little bit about Venus activating the Saturn-Uranus square. And yeah, I'm excited to see how this plays out. So I will catch you next time. Thank you so much for joining me today. If you're looking for more astrology in your world, you can connect with me on Instagram, Twitter, Patreon. You can book your reading with me on my website. And if you're looking to study astrology, I've got some new classes posted, so definitely go ahead and check those out.